after the war, there was the second wave of, let's say, attempts to interpretation of quantum mechanics. And up to the second wave, so up to the 50s, 60s, we did not know a way to distinguish these two approaches, psi-ontic or psi-epistemic. We thought, okay, everything, this is kind of a philosophical question, everything is allowed. But then, this is what I think your question was leading to, in the 60s, a guy named Bell kind of came up with a relation between correlated quantities. So you have, I did not talk about it right now, but you have something that is called entangled particles in quantum mechanics. So what happens when two particles interact and interact in a very special coherent way? In quantum mechanics, these two particles are linked in some way, and the correlations between results of this linked particle in some almost magical way relates to the experimental results of something that I can measure that consists in taking the two particles, making it interlink in some way in a given location, and then evolving them two separately and sending them in two different places and then measuring them separately. And so by measuring them in this setting, then I can kind of figure out if they were linked or not by the means of correlations. And
Andrea, could you make an example? Concrete example using whatever you like, spin or
yeah,
to so, have a visual idea of a
so a visual of... idea. It's usually it's done with spin, but well, it's also done with polarization. So you know that photons have this possibility of polarizing, of being polarized. What it means is that the wave that describe the electromagnetic wave, it has a very definite direction. So the direction of propagation of the wave, the direction of the magnetic and electric fields that make this wave propagate are very well defined when you have a polarized beam. So this is used, for example, for glasses. So if you have a polarized glasses, they reflect less. And this is because they kill all the components that are not synchronized with the polarization of your glasses. And so if you take two glasses that are polarized and you shift them and you make one on top of the other and you start to shift, then you observe that you have this, that it looks like it gets dark, simply because you are killing all the components apart from a special direction. And with the other glass that is in front of your first, you are killing all the other components. And when you arrive to killing all the other components except the perpendicular one, then you killed all the components. So if you make this beam go through two polarized glasses, then you can get pitch dark. And this is also done with 3D glasses. 3D glasses are only polarized in different direction, and a 3D screen sends you different pictures with different polarization, and then they go into one of all the two glasses. And if you take the 3D glasses and you tilt them one on the other, you can do this experiment. Unfortunately, I don't have it here. So this, you can make two photons intertwine and have opposite polarization. So you make them in exactly this way that I explained. So you make them and you make them run through polarizing filters, and you make sure that one of the two photons has one polarization and the other has the opposite, is perpendicular. And if you do like this, then you can take one of the two photons and make them evolve and guide the photons into two fiber optic cables and guide them into two distant places. It's done even, well, nowadays it's done even on satellites, bouncing with satellites. But It was up to 10 years ago when I was a PhD student, it came a guy, famous guy named Zeilinger, and he explained this experiment done. And he was sending in the Galapagos Island, I think, and was sending one beam with fiber optic cable on one island and another beam with fiber optic cable on another island and make this experiment. So that if the larger you make it, the more precise you are. So it was just fun to see that you can make it that large. So we're very good in managing electromagnetic waves because our whole technology is based on this electromagnetic. And as we can make 3D screens, we can also use this to physics experiment at large scale. Okay, and then what we measure is the polarization. So we have another polarizing filter at the end of these two very long fiber optic cables. And then we measure with this polarizing filter, okay, what does this at the right have polarization up, or it has polarization perpendicular sides? And you do the same with the other guy. Is this polarization up or polarization perpendicular? Since you constructed the state at your source location in a way that they were perpendicular to each other, you know that if you measure this one here that has polarization up, you know, vertical, you know that the other one on the other island will have perpendicular polarization horizontal. Just because, I mean, you made them like this at your source, you made them evolved, and you know that you haven't disturbed the system in any way. So you know that one it's up, one it's vertical and the other is horizontal. So if you measure one to be vertical, the other will be horizontal, and vice versa. So then you can, by making a mathematical operation, that is actually feasible. I will not attempt today, but we can try some other time, or I can give an example some other time, make a video on my own. And this is only a probability thing. You can make it with whatever. You can take a couple and guess if they want red wine or white wine, and you can make the same thing, as long as you kind of, you can figure out by looking at when, how much do they answer red and how much do they answer white, or in this case, how much you measure vertical and how much you measure horizontal, you can figure out if they have, if they were synchronized at the beginning. So if the couple talked at the beginning, okay, order white and you order red, or not, or in this case, if they were synchronized at the beginning. So by simply measuring how many times does it happen that these measures are correlated. It's a little bit, there is some mathematics in between, because once you measure this in one way, you know that the other is the other way. So there is not really point of measuring it, and vice versa. So you have to do some mathematics to kind of realize how they relate to each other. So, but in this way, you can rule out a whole set of interpretation of quantum mechanics. So this was where we began. So by this rule, that is a probabilistic rule, you can rule out a whole set of interpretation of quantum mechanics that say that the wave function is ontic, so it has a physical meaning, and therefore, when I split this beam in two and I send it to two different islands, it means that I have this wave, it's definitely horizontally or vertically, and this other way is definitely horizontally. So it is physically like this, and they are physically like this since the beginning, and they evolve like this. And you can kind of figure out that if it is this ontic thing, then, and you measure in a given way in this example, to the beams to be vertical and horizontal, then the only thing that can happen is that these two have communicated even when you measure them. But if they are on two different islands, very, very far away from each other, the way that they have to communicate is very, very fast. And then if you do your experiment cleverly enough, rapidly enough, you can kind of rule out if they communicated faster than light or not. So if they are violating special relativity or not. So basically, this rule out a whole set of interpretation. So the set of interpretation that was called psiontic with hidden variables and locality. So if you consider this wave function to be a real object, if you consider that these real objects are not probabilistic in and of itself, are not probabilistic objects, are not distributions that are intrinsically probabilistic, but are representation of an underlying structure that we don't know and it's hidden in some way, then the only way that this can be through is by these two, by communicating faster than light in a real physical way. So in a realist way. But this cannot happen because of special relativity, and we know that that special relativity is an even more tested theory of reality. So the only way is considered that either this is not real, so it's not nature, the wave function is not nature, and this so either the wave function is not something intrinsic of nature, or the wave function is intrinsically a probabilistic distribution, or you have to admit that reality is a little bit weird. So in a sense, you have to admit that reality behaves in one way when I do a certain set of experiments and behaves in another way when I do another set of experiments. Of course, scientists don't like it because we assume that that nature is real and behaves in a coherent way, because otherwise our experiment will not have much sense. So we dislike that hypothesis, but philosophically you can still consider, okay, this is happens in a way because reality does not obey by your rule. And even if you figure out that this is the rule that you want to have, reality say otherwise, and it's in the power of reality to just screw your experiment all over the place. And okay, we physicists don't like it, but that's a possibility. On the other hand, if you admit that that there is a reality that behaves well with experiments, so that can be scientifically investigated in a sense with the science that we know and we are doing right now, then you have to admit that either the wave function is non, it's not real. So it's not an ontological structure, but is an epistemic structure. Does not codify what nature is, but only what information does nature have, and we can extract. Or you have to admit that this distribution is probabilistic in nature. So it cannot be that the structure of this of the electron, or in this case of the photon, the energy of the photon splits in several packets that are sent in different places in the Galapagos Island, but it has to be that what is split is the probability of one state to be found on one island and another state to be found on another island. So I hope this was a little bit complicated and long-winded, but
no, sure, thank you very much. And